Folks, so this is a quick guide about shortcodes. Shortcodes are one of my favorite features in WordPress, although they're kind of ugly for non-programmers. But they're super great for programmers and developers because they make enough sense to us. So what's a shortcode? Well, we've got an example here on the left. I'll zoom my browser a little bit just so that's even clearer. What you see is this QG shortcode, stands for Quick Guide Shortcode. Again, programmers understand that perfectly. Maybe an average end user doesn't. But so we see a text before the shortcode and text after. If I edit this post, we see that this looks basically identical on the back end. So if I go through and I want to actually, what shortcodes enable is they allow me to dump the output of a program into the body of a post. So in this case, this is just a simple example. How do I replace that QG shortcode with the output of a function? Well, I need to use the WordPress function called addShortcode, and that takes two arguments. One is the name of the shortcode. In our case, it's QG shortcode. Basically, the first argument here is the name that goes inside the square brackets of the shortcode, and the second one is the name of our function. I'm going to call mine the same. I'm going to call it QG shortcode. Obviously, if this were a plugin where I had lots of shortcodes, that would be a bad name. But for our case, our purposes, it'll work. When you're just calling a shortcode with no arguments, this is the default way. Maybe in a future quick guide, we'll deal with arguments to shortcodes. But for right now, your function doesn't need to take any arguments. And WordPress will just show whatever you return there. So if I return hi, make sure it's a string, which is, by putting it in quotes of some kind, we'll now see hi in place of the shortcode. Perfect. All right. The next thing to realize, though, is that you don't want to echo in a shortcode. And that's because the way WordPress works, if you echo it, the shortcode will have been called before the place in the text it should be inserted. So your echoed things will come up at the top of the content area. You could maybe use this as a quick hack, but it's generally not a good idea. You should put the shortcode where you want the output to come out, and you should return in the shortcode. So that's the basics of shortcodes. Now, I do want to show one of the things that I love about using shortcodes as a WordPress developer, especially when I sometimes need to do quick and dirty things that I'm not going to go ahead and do test-driven development or anything for. And basically what I love about shortcodes inside of a WordPress context is they're the quickest way I can get some output onto the screen from inside of a couple WordPress function calls or something. So here I've got this QG shortcode, and it's returning a string. But it can also return the output of this other function. Add is a kind of trivial functional example, but if I use this function, I say add 3, 4, I can now see that 7 is coming out. Whereas if I had an error in the function, I could see the negative one. This is a crude method of test-driven development, really. But test-driven development, I wouldn't have to refresh my browser and see that with human eyes. The test would write it. But for quick and dirty WordPress stuff, obviously add is a trivial example. But for quick and dirty WordPress stuff, that is where shortcodes really shine, is that they get you feedback on the screen very quickly. Obviously, they're good in the long term when you need to put an order form or just like a contact form or something into a page. That's where shortcodes are used appropriately in WordPress all the time. But this is kind of a simple version that hopefully gets you up to speed about how you make a shortcode in WordPress. All right.